This is the long-awaited Home Assistant Voice PE. Finally, it's here. The voice assistant from Home Assistant that is supposed to make Google Home, Siri and Alexa obsolete. But is that really the case? In this video, I'll share my experiences with you. A few weeks ago, the Home Assistant Voice PE was secretly sent to all official Home Assistant content creators. We were among the first to try out the Voice PE and share our experiences in a special Discord channel. By the way, PE stands for Preview Edition. I was really excited when I received the Voice PE, but it's not perfect. I'll tell you more about that later. I thought the box would be quite large, but it's just a small box measuring 9.5 by 9 centimeters. Inside the box you'll find a sticker, a card with a QR code for accessing installation instructions, the warranty terms and, of course, the Voice PE itself. The Voice PE is only 8.5 by 8.5 centimeters in size, with a USB-C port and an audio out jack. There's also a button to mute the microphone. In the center there's a white button and a rotary dial that let you adjust the volume and the color of the indicator LED. That's all there is to it. I couldn't imagine the volume of the built-in speaker being loud enough, but trust me, it gets very loud. Installing it is very simple. Once you connect the Voice PE with a USB-C cable, which by the way isn't included, it's immediately detected by Home Assistant. You just need to click Add and then Submit to start the installation process. The interface will then ask for your Wi-Fi, SSID and password. After that, you need to press the button on the Voice PE to authorize it, and it gets added to your network. In the next step, you add the Voice PE to ESP Home, and it will automatically update itself. Once that's done, you can try out the wake word. I won't say it out loud here, since it might trigger a voice assistant in your home. And with that, the Voice PE is installed. The installation process is super simple. In a previous video, I explained in detail how to set up the voice assistant software in Home Assistant so it works either locally or via Home Assistant Cloud, as well as how to use ChatGPT to control your home. Be sure to check out that video too, especially if you want to use ChatGPT or OpenAI. The link is in the description of this video. With the Home Assistant voice assistants, you can control devices in your home directly using your voice, such as turning a light on or off. You can also make use of so-called large language models. Personally, I use OpenAI or ChatGPT. That's when things get really exciting, because you can not only ask the voice assistant general questions, but also request it to adjust the colors of your lights based on specific events. And you don't even need to create scenes in Home Assistant for this. I'll now briefly show you a few examples of commands you can give to the Voice PE.
Backlight off.
Turned off the light.
Backlight on.
Turned on the light.
Dim the lights in the office.
I dimmed the lights in the office to a brightness level of 20. If you need any further adjustments or specific colors, feel free to let me know.
Make the office brighter.
I've increased the brightness of the lights in the office to a brighter setting. If you need further adjustments or would like to set specific colors, just let me know.
My girlfriend is visiting me. Adjust the colors in the office accordingly.
I've adjusted the brightness of the lights in the office to create a warm ambience for your girlfriend's visit. For additional warmth and a romantic touch, consider using the Home Assistant app to choose warm colors like soft pink or warm white. Enjoy your time together.
Set the different lights in the office to a Christmas atmosphere.
The different lights in the office have been set to a Christmas atmosphere with festive colors. Enjoy the holiday spirit.
Office scene cozy.
The office scene cozy has been activated. You should now have a warm and inviting atmosphere in your office. Enjoy your cozy space.
Can you tell me who the founder is of Home Assistant?
Home Assistant was founded by Paula Schatzen in 2013. He started the project to create a home automation platform that would allow users to control their smart home devices more effectively and securely. Since then, Home Assistant has grown significantly and is supported by a vibrant community of developers and users.
Can you tell me more about him?
Paula Schatzen is a software engineer and the founder of Home Assistant, an open-source home automation platform. He started the project in 2013 to provide a solution for integrating various smart home devices and systems, focusing on privacy and local control rather than relying on cloud services. Paulus has been actively involved in the development of Home Assistant.
Additionally, you can use the Voice PE as a media player, streaming music to it via Music Assistant, for instance. So, what does the Voice PE cost and where can you buy it? The Voice PE costs $59. At the time of making this video, the final URL where you can purchase the Voice PE wasn't confirmed, but you can find that link in the description of this video. And now, my conclusion about the Voice PE. I'm going to be honest with you, the Voice PE is not yet ready to replace Google Home, Siri or Alexa. There are still quite a few software updates needed. It often fails to understand what you mean or can't execute certain commands. For example, I asked it to adjust the lighting for a romantic evening, but it kept saying it couldn't change the colors. However, when I asked it to set the colors to match Christmas, it worked just fine. Personally, I don't mind if it doesn't understand me sometimes, but my housemates are far less patient with it. Another thing to consider is that if you want to use OpenAI, you'll need a subscription. The cost is only a few cents per request though. Today I tested it intensively with 263 requests to OpenAI, which cost me 81 cents. For Google Home, I don't have to pay anything yet, but I've read on sites like The Verge that they're also planning to charge for AI functionality. So yes, the Home Assistant Voice PE is a fun gadget for tech enthusiasts, but I don't think it's quite ready for the less tech-savvy consumer. And if you want to keep your housemates happy, I'd recommend sticking with Google Home, Siri or Alexa for now. Thank you for watching. If you enjoyed this review, please like, comment and subscribe for more content. You can also sponsor me for the price of a coffee per month, just like these people have already done. Without your support, this channel cannot continue to exist. You can find links to Patreon, Ko-fi and how to become a paid member of this channel in the description of this video. Your support means a lot. I'll see you soon in my next video. Bye bye! What? Installation instructions. The voice of Home Assistant.